So I'm pretty sure I need to kill a few of these tomb robbers, so I'm just going to spank a few of these guys. So he's probably going to survive long enough for me to bother transforming into bear, maybe not. Probably kill this one. I'll build up 75 wrath, go attack the other one, transform to bear, and bear slap. Bear slap OP. Okay, look. They might be orange, but they just got splatted. That's brilliant. Challenger's entered the fray. I shall attack him with bees. Get him, bees. Bang. There we go. Right, so we have various bits and pieces that we have to collect from around the shore. And somebody's sending me messages. So various pieces of oil and wood and driftwood and that. We need to kill various robbers at Barad Tharsir. So Barad Tharsir is this ruins over on the east side of the Brandywine. We need to collect bundles of rope, pieces of driftwood, small flywheels. There's one. What other quests have we got here? Let's have a look. So search the rubble at the ancient lighthouse. That's back on the hill to the west. Soggy Weed's got to take back to town. Take that back to town. Yep. And then there's five entrances to Barad Tharsir. Okay, so this is going to be an exercise in trying not to overpull too much, because although Beorning is pretty strong, these guys are yellow and orange, so they're fairly tough. We don't want to, you know, bite off a bit too much than we can chew. I probably don't want to be fighting too many of these guys. I've got a named one here as part of a particular quest. Be a quest to kill. I think there's three different named guys in these ruins, like the leaders of the this particular band of bandits. No pun intended. Okay, so there's an unmarked room, but we don't have that quest yet. Okay. So there are going to be five entrances to these ruins. We need to scout them all. So obviously. That doorway is pretty obviously going to be one of them. So if we run over here, might have to go through it. I don't want to go through there until I've killed these guys first. Okay, one dead. So something you're going to notice as well, we're actually getting reputation for killing each and every bandit we come across. So there we go. So we're getting 8 reputation with the Wardens of Animinus, who are basically rangers. So where am I looking? Is it literally the doors to downstairs? In which case, I'm looking at the wrong things. So this should update. There we go. Right, so it's doors to the underground parts of this place. Yeah, in addition to getting reputation for killing bandits, they're also going to drop some of the reputation items for this area. Where are they? Tomb Raider sashes. I'll just drag them into my bags. So, as with most of the early game regions, there are three types of three types of reputation, which will give you either 30 points, 50 points, or 700 points. So the Tomb Raider's sashes are the most basic form of reputation item for Evendim, so you can get loads of these. Personally, I'd say hang on to them, don't consume them as you get them, because you will get a hell of a lot of reputation from doing the quests in Animinus, and you'll probably get kindred just from doing quests, so you can probably just hold on to those for another character, or maybe sell them on the auction house to get a load of money. Okay, there's another one of the named guys. So I've still got pretty much full wrath built up, so I'll just transform into a bear and crap in his face. Like that. There we go, look, more than half health in one attack. Strong. Okay, so we've defeated the amount of tomb robbers we needed. So we can remove that one. So you guys probably can't see it too well on YouTube, but there are some quest rings for the entrances quest, and I'm pointing directly at one of them, so it's probably up here somewhere. Could be that door there, I'd imagine. Let's just murder these guys. Stick the bees on this woman. Just do a quick heal on myself, just to top me up. Come here. Not allowed to run away. Okay, so this should hopefully be second entrance, yep. I can just nick that supply chest. Lovely, lovely. So, because the Beorning is based on the building and consuming of Wrath, and they don't have power, the Beorning's skills obviously don't require power. You can use them providing the cooldown is up. So they're a lot more reliant on their skill cooldowns than other classes. And unlike other classes that can run out of power and therefore can't really do anything, the Beorning doesn't really have that problem. They can just carry on spamming their abilities, and if they don't have any abilities that they can spam that consume Wrath, there's always like half their skills which are available for building Wrath. So they pretty much can keep on going forever, like a Duracell bunny or something. Bang. Right. Oh, I probably should have stayed in bear form if I'd seen that guy. Oh well. So there are some quite interesting synergies as well that you can build with the Beorning class that I've noticed. When you use certain abilities, or if you trait the ability a certain way, you can get a heal if you attack from behind with it and things like that, which are pretty interesting, but I'm not going to like go over every possible tactic you can use to make yourself pretty OP. But just while I heal up, I'm just going to sit here. I'm going to bake myself a honey cake, which is one of the Beorning's racial traits. You literally get a skill which enables you to make yourself a free honey cake. It doesn't cost any materials. Where is it? There it is. Which just gives us some in-combat power regen, which obviously power regen doesn't affect us, but we can give these to our allies and they'll be happy with a bit of power regen. And some in-combat morale regen, and then out of combat morale and power regen as well. So they last for 5 minutes once you eat them, and you can eat the next one 30 seconds later if you want. But they're quite nice. You can just make them as you go along and just like chug those to regen a bit of morale, not power, but morale basically out of combat for the Beorning itself. So what have we got left? We need two more entrances. And there's some more rope and driftwood which should both be down near the river, so probably didn't actually need to aggro these guys as soon as the door was grabbed, but do it anyway. Bees! Got a bee allergy, just got killed by the bees. Right, let's come through here. Now, bear in mind, for a later quest actually, you will need to click on that bottle for one of the pickup quests. There are two more doors. I know where one of them is. One of them is apparently right below me. So it is. Well, that's one way of finding it. So let's kill this one, transform into a bear for the next one. Die. Bang. See, bear form is OP. It's just ridiculous. Bear in mind as well, I do have a damage bonus for like 30% critical damage in bear form, which is strong. Now I'm going to have to walk out the entrance because I can't actually sneak out any other way, so we're going to end up aggroing these two, and knowing my luck there'll be a third one patrolling nearby or something. That's okay. So one last door, which is going to be this door over here. So to summarise then, there's one to the left of the ruins, one to the right of the ruins, and three inside the ruins. So tag that. We need to go back to the Colossus with this quest, so I'll just remove that for now. So we need 5 bits of rope and 1 piece of driftwood. So I can see a piece of driftwood down there. I think the rope is more on the bend. We should hopefully see once I update the quest. So it could be anywhere. Probably to the north though. Let's go this way. Because we need it to any around here. But the lighthouse that we need for the other quest should be, lighthouse in the loosest terms, but it should be those ruins on that hill over there. So we'll have to swim back across at some point. Okay, there's one rope. I think they're all should be pretty close to the river if there are any. Can't see any more. Might just be this one on this side. I thought there used to be more. Ah, there's one. There we are. All these lovely bits of ore deposits as well that I'm collecting. So it seems then we've got 3, but there are little mini circles for each of those ropes. So the other 4, I mean, there must be 7 ropes then, but only need 6 of them to advance the quest. So we're going to have to go back down south. So just to give you guys a bit of a basic overview then on the Beorning's man skills while I'm riding back down south. So first one you see on my toolbar is going to be the transform skill. So that's the one that enables me to transform back and forth to bear stance as I want. So I can use that any time. There is a 5-second cooldown on transforming, or once I transform back from a bear to a man, the cooldown triggers. So, because I'm traded for it in the red line, I get plus 30% melee damage as a bear, on top of the normal skill damage. But being in bear form will require us to have at least one wrath in order to transform into a bear. And while we're in the bear form, we consume 3 wrath points every 3 seconds. So, 1 wrath every second, which isn't really a lot, but you know. It adds up a little bit over time. So then my second skill. I'm pretty sure I need to stay on this side of the river. Maybe not. It reckons there's one up there. I reckon it's lying, but whatever. So the second skill I've got on my toolbars is Slash. So this is one you'll have at the start of the game. Which is just 1 second cooldown. You can pretty much spam that and just slap somebody with your great axe or whatever weapon you're using. I'm running out of land here. Is this still the direction I'm meant to be going? It could be rope over there. That is rope. Okay, so Slash normally just does some straight up damage. I think it's because I've got a particular trait in the red tree that it's now got a bleed on it as well. And that bleed stacks up to 3 times, if I'm not mistaken, doing increasing more damage. So that's pretty nice, since that's your bread and butter attack. Third skill I've got on my toolbars is called Slam. So I'll just bring that up. So Slam, again, it's a fairly short cooldown, 3 seconds. You literally do just smack someone on the head with your great axe or hammer or whatever. It's pretty cool. But this goes back to what I was saying before about skills that can have some pretty interesting synergy if you trade for them. So in this case, I'm not traded for it, but if I was to slam somebody from behind, if I had traded with it, I could get hills. And I'm not entirely sure the magnitude of those hills, but I imagine it's pretty nice. So if I was in a group, it would be a lot easier. So somebody else is tanking the mobs, I can get behind the mobs and just spam slam. I can pretty much top myself up with all the heals that I could possibly ever need, which is pretty sweet. At the moment, I haven't traded with that since I'm mostly soloing at the moment, so the odds of me being able to get into position behind a mob without it just turning around to face me are pretty slim, so I've left that trait for now. So the fourth skill is one that's called Expose. So this one, again, this is another one that has a pretty interesting synergy with other stuff. So it's another one that does straight up damage. It also gives minus 40% targets mitigation. Now, something I've noticed, okay, I'm meant to be just checking random rubble until I find what I'm looking for. So this buff isn't applied to the mob that you use it on. It's a buff that gets applied to yourself. So if I show you guys, if I just come and slap that sand lurker in the face, I get this buff on myself. So expose weakness, minus 40% target mitigation, and that will last on myself. So if I change target, I still penetrate through 40% of the enemy's physical mitigation, which is pretty damn strong. But there is a trait in the red line, and this one which I have traited, which means if I was to transform into a bear while that effect is on me, my 8-second duration will refresh. So if I was to transform with only 2 seconds left on the buff into a bear, that would last for a further 8 seconds instead of timing out after 2 seconds. So it just means if you manage your transformations into a bear at the right time, you can basically crap on it for ages. And it also means, obviously, if you use expose as part of any kind of man rotation before you transform into a bear, your bear attacks, which already do way more damage, are going to do even more damage because you're just going to ignore most of what the target's got for armor to reduce your physical attacks. So that's pretty damn strong. And my fifth basic skill is one called Biting Edge. So this is an AoE attack which hits up to 5 targets. For some reason the range is 5.2 meters. I guess I just have a long reach with my axe. Normal melee attacks are only 2.5 meters. So this is another manform attack, hits 5 targets within a 5 meter radius, does a quick double attack, so you see 2 attacks there. And that also adds quite a lot of wrath to my wrath bar, which is quite nice. Okay, so let's hand in all these quests then.
Take a moment of your time
before I get too far.
Greetings. Would you do something for me?
He's got one.
What do you need?
So see, I'm getting quite a bit of XP for all this, which is quite nice. So Evendim was
service. Could I speak with you a moment?
It was revamped update 2, I think, a good few years ago now, shortly after free to play.
What do you
need? So, it's a lot more streamlined than it used to be. It always used to be quite a nice region.
Might I take a moment of your time?
But it's now a lot more streamlined around these various quest hubs. So, for example, this quest hub never used to exist in the original version of Evendim.